Anybody who tells you not to carve an axe handle out of some Osage orange, out of some Bear Dark, don't listen to them. This is a piece of Osage orange. Let's get a zip back a little bit. That was cut from a fence post in 1990. At least that's what they say. I don't know if you can trust it or not, but it looks pretty seasoned on the outside. So I got this half round and then I got a full round, both about 27 and a half, 28 inches long. And with this piece here, looks straight enough. I'm going to carve a new handle for this guy. An old Forest Service cruiser axe. There's old Burgle in the background chilling. It's hot. Real hot today. But yeah, I'm gonna carve a new handle for this cruising axe. I've never carved a handle out of Osage orange. It's gonna be my first time. I've carved plenty of handles out of locust, and from what I gather, they work the same. I have started working on a couple bows I've been carving out of Osage orange. I got them about halfway done. Now I'm gonna let them season for a good long while before I go messing with it anymore. I guess they're about a year and a half since they were cut from the tree. So it's seasoned enough, but I figured the longer I wait, the better. But this is a locust handle I carved. I have a couple more laying around different spots, but as far as I know, Osage orange and locust kind of work the same. So now I don't know about 30-year-old seasoned for 30 years fence post might be a little hard, might not. Guess we're gonna find out. Excited. I've been waiting on this for a little while now, so it'd be nice to get two handles out of it. I see it's starting to split in here and here. I was thinking about splitting it right here, and then there's a good possibility I can get a handle out of this section here, and I can get a good handle out of this section. Or look at the other end down here. There's that same little split. We're gonna see how she goes. Don't wanna screw it up. This is all I got. This here's a neat little hatchet I got at a flea market. I think I paid like $10 for this thing. I'm gonna carve a handle for it eventually, but it looks like an old plum pattern. There ain't any markings on it. It's been cleaned up and grinded up a little bit. good boy. It's hot, dude. I know. We're gonna go get in the river in a little bit. All right, we'll get cooled off. All right, let's see what we got. So, I think I'm gonna have to save this guy. It'd be kind of tricky. I think I might save this for a hatchet handle. Something along those lines. But right here, I think we're going to use this guy here. Just barely wide enough. Just barely long enough. Just barely wide enough. Wouldn't that have sucked? It's hot. I know. Well, you gotta be calm. You gotta be a calm boy. It's too hot. It'll get cooled off in a couple months. Go on around. Go do something. Just gotta keep on working her down. Ultimate goal is to have it, the shoulder seating down, touching everywhere. I got a long ways to go. Just be able to take this little angle here and get it up just in where I need to. Big help. I only want to take material off where it's already rubbing. Keep on working her down. I got a long way to go. It's about that mark there. I'm gonna keep on at it.
Go. Goodbye. Go.
A little bit peeking out. See how she looks.
Good boy.
Come on, boys. Let's go.
Thank you. What are you doing, big boy? All right, look at it. Wrong spot, dude.
Anybody who tells you not to carve an axe handle out of some Osage orange, out of some Bear Dark, don't listen to them. They're a knucklehead. It's a beautiful wood. It's a strong wood. And I just put it to the test, and it feels real good in my hand. Hickory is probably the king, but after carving this handle out of some Osage orange, I'd say I'm a big fan of it, and I will continue to carve axe handles out of Osage orange. You know, I've carved them out of apple, I've carved them out of locust, hickory, white oak, red oak. They all held up. I even carved a handle one time out of a big old driftwood board that I'd found along the river that was very likely pine. and it held up just fine. I used that handle for a long time. It never broke either. I ended up just cutting it off and carving a new one for the axe because I like carving axe handles. But real happy with this handle. I tried to keep her nice and thin and old school, like it was, like the old handle was from this axe. I wish I could have left the old handle on, but it just had too much cracking up towards the eye there, so is what it is. But I'm really happy with this handle, and I hope y'all enjoy this video. About 2 pound head, ended up being about a 27 inch handle on it. Really happy with it. I guess it's time to get back down the mountain. Hope y'all enjoyed the video. I'll catch you on the next one.
See ya.
All right, let's go, Bubba. Let's go. Bandu. Come on, Virgil. Old man. Presidential plants. Good boy, Bonzo.